Might as well just start it already. Get her done.
Who are them goddamn fools out there reading scriptures? Cussing.
Cussing. Y'all use curse words? Keep your Bible.
Cuss. What's up, man? You an Israelite? You ain't an Israelite? I heard that. I told you before you got here, he said, well, like, looking like that, can't get the truth. He confirmed it. What'd he say? Spirit of the Lord gonna be on these people, man, when that time comes, man. They gonna know they Israelite then, cause that's the only way they gonna have shame and guilt, you know, and feel pitiful as fuck. Cause they gonna know, the Lord gonna wake them up, put them in their fucking stupid ass heads and shit, you know? Oh, dumb motherfucker. Might as well start with a scripture that's proving these people are stupid. Look, Jeremiah 4 or Hosea 4. Fuck, that dumb. Oh, dumb motherfuckers. Pastor Pork Chopper, take that motherfucker in and, hey, you brother, you a brother, you wisdom. You deep. And the nigga ain't saying shit but look retarded as fuck. Buck teeth and shit. What does buck teeth look like? It's a clown on it's a fool on the Bugs Bunny cartoon motherfucker walk around looking stupid as fuck.
Okay. It's Jeremiah 4:22. For my people is foolish. They have not known me. They are sardis children.
That's right. Like the Lord just said, they have not known me. They are foolish. You know? And sardis means stupid. Stupid.
Our people is retarded as hell.
All right. We're going to prove it right here with this one. But watch. We're going to just prove it.
For my people is foolish, they have not known me. They are Sardis children, and they have What's none up, understanding.
What's up, man? You know you're an Israelite?
Sorry?
You know you're an Israelite?
No.
You know that? Really? Straight up?
No.
What's your nationality?
Myself.
Yourself?
Yes,
ain't a nationality, bro.
It's this, you
know, it's well, it's proven by point again. You know, you're an Israelite. You know, ain't no such thing as yourself, man.
Okay.
You know, we so-called Israelites, you know.
Okay.
I say so-called Israelites. We're Israelites. Mm-hmm.
You know, well, actually so-called, we're the people of the Bible. Really Yasharala.
Thank you, bro. Thank you. Yeah. Yasharala, that's Hebrew for Israel.
Mm-hmm.
He is Prince of Power.
Yeah.
Right. Go on and read that, bro.
That's Jeremiah 4:22. For my people is foolish. They have not known me. They are Sardis children.
You think somebody could be walking around here with not knowing anything? You think that soul is destroyed.
I'm hearing what you're saying. Sure.
They have none understanding. They are wise to do evil, but to do good, they have no knowledge.
No. That don't describe our people perfectly. Look at all these people out here. Look how they act, foolish as them. They even tell you, I'm finna act a fool tonight.
Ooh.
That's all they about, foolishness. Yeah. All they care about is getting high, getting drunk.
Not we all.
Committing adultery.
Not we all. We all got to have it. We all went through it, but some of us waking up. Some of us going to remain asleep. Some of us going to remain asleep. Now, the people who the Lord is referring to that are these sodish children, these foolish people, these people that was told their nationality, like I told you, you're in Hebrew Israelite. Those that hear, that's your nationality, but reject it. And go on, like you said, with your own thing. I'm not saying you, but I'm just saying, as an example, somebody, you hear enlightenment, you're hearing the truth, but you're rejecting the truth. Those are the people who the Lord is referring to as fools, the people that reject the truth.
Yes.
You know? The same people that rejected the Lord when he was walking the earth.
What
they say, let his blood be on us and our children.
Didn't Pontius Pilate said, what, you want me to crucify your king? They said, we have no king but Caesar, crucify him. You know what I'm saying? Because these people, they put more trust in the government and they put more trust in their slave masters than they do the Lord. That's why every 4 years they got the election cycle, we in it right now. And they think they're going to have that new Messiah going to come and save them.
Barack was old.
Yeah, Barack Obama, all that, where'd all the hope and change go? I see the same shit that
he made it. That's all I know, he made it. Dude.
What you mean he made it?
He made what?
He made what?
8 years, baby. That's what
eight,
I'm talking about.
8 years of what? 8 years.
What did he make, though? I don't understand what you're saying.
What are you
sexual?
Yeah, he ain't even our people. He ain't even a Negro. And first of all, he wasn't, you and the other people didn't put him in office.
What he do for us? Not a goddamn thing.
Right.
That's how y'all think he did that for
us? Okay, well, tell us what he do for us.
What he do?
What he do
The hoods is still there.
What he do? It's he made history, man.
What's history? What history, man?
What kind of history?
First time we made.
Homosexuals can get married.
Martin Luther King
predicted this before.
Martin Luther King was
like, we ain't never had a black president ever, and this is the first time ever. Are you serious?
He ain't black, though.
Who ain't black?
Barack Obama is not a so-called Negro. Listen, bro. Barack Obama is not a so-called Negro.
Okay.
You are a so-called Negro.
Hey, get the,
His dad is just from Kenya.
You got the dictionary,
his
bro?
His dad's from Kenya. Oh, yeah.
Get the, show him the Bible dictionary. Because what country is he from? He's from Kenya.
That's part of
Africa. Africa, there's many nations in Africa, though. You know what I'm saying? Africa's the biggest continent on the planet with hundreds and hundreds of nations in it. You know what I'm saying? So he comes from the total opposite part of Africa than all the Jakes in America come from.
That's right.
Totally different.
Okay, listen, bro. Listen.
He does not descend from slaves either. He don't descend from slaves.
That's right.
There ain't no descendant of slaves in the White House.
Right.
Never will be.
And check it out. You remember when him and Michelle went over there?
Yeah.
He was telling Michelle, your people serve slavery here.
Yeah.
Your people. He was saying to her, your people. He said, your people. Mm-hmm. See, he knows he's not. He was talking to his wife. His wife isn't us. His wife is an Israelite.
Yep.
His wife is, but he's not.
Nah.
Okay, but listen, just listen. This is the Bible dictionary, okay?
And
Ham is a name that's in the Bible.
Obama's a Hamite.
Right, Ham, when you have a movie, you have the...
Obama's a what?
He's a Hamite.
He's a Hamite.
He's a descendant from the Hamites, spoken on in the Bible. You got three main forefathers of all nations on earth come from either Ham, Shem, or Japheth. The Israelites come from Shem. So he got it right here for you.
Right.
Check
Ham.
This out.
This is Ham, the definition of Ham. The youngest son of Noah. Okay, I bet you your phone don't pick it up.
Oh, you can go.
Okay. But let me read this to you anyway.
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
The youngest son of Noah. You know about Noah?
Noah
in the Bible. Yeah. Noah was the father of the three sons and their wives and his wife.
Okay. Yeah,
okay. The youngest son of Noah, born probably about 96 years before the flood, and one of eight persons to live through the flood, okay? He became the progenitor. Progenitor means
forefather.
Of the dark races. He became the progenitor of the dark races, not the Negroes.
Not the Negroes.
But
see?
The Egyptians, the Ethiopians, Libyans, and Canaanites. This is the Bible dictionary. We gave you the definition of Ham. Who he's through. Who, right. We're from Shem. We're Shemite.
Yeah, like the ancient...
Ham in the Bible dictionary.
Right.
Because originally all the nations were dark-skinned people anyway. Like, the ancient Egyptians, those were Hamites. They enslaved us going back, thousands and thousands of years ago.
Just like
you know what I'm saying?
Just like now.
Just like now.
Yeah, right.
That's why what's on the back of a dollar
bill?
What's on the back of a dollar bill? It's an Egyptian pyramid.
Just, we out here only for the sole purpose of enlightenment, brother. You see what I'm saying?
Oh,
we out
go.
Here for enlightenment.
What you got there? You got an Egyptian pyramid with the eye of Horus right there. That represents the god of the Egyptians. Now let me get you a scripture. Because the Israelites and the ancient Egyptians, they both was dark-skinned people, but they was not related. Because in these schools in America, they teach people lies. They'll say, the blacks in America descend from Egyptians. And that's a lie. And the ancient Egyptians were our adversaries.
How else, Marquis, that's the number one way of destroying a nation is destroying their mind.
Yep.
You know? See, by them erasing our history, which that's the Bible, it's our history. I mean, we don't have no strength and no power there. So
no.
We don't know how great of a people we really are. But right now, you don't see nothing. You don't even see a remnant of greatness, you know?
Right.
Except the word.
Except the word. Check this. Deuteronomy 26:6. This is what the Bible said about the Egyptians. And the Egyptians evil entreated us and afflicted us and laid upon us hard bondage. That's what the Egyptians did to us. And you can still see, they got Egyptian symbols, like on a dollar. You'll see they got sun hieroglyphs all over the place out here. Oh, did you know that even at the state house over there, you know that's a pagan temple? Look at it. Look at it.
Spiritual balls.
Well, you just looks like a temple, don't it?
Oh, yeah.
That's because it is a temple.
So it's similar to a temple?
No, it is a temple.
It is a temple?
They call it a state house, but really it's a temple. You don't want to go up in there after hours.
Yeah, you really don't.
We ain't joking, bro.
Right, right.
This whole country is ran by...
You don't want to go in there.
Nah, you don't want
to. You find yourself on a table.
Yeah, have your ass on the altar.
Fuck around, I've been at work.
And then Mayor Coleman going to come out with that knife. And John Kasich.
Hey, man, it's good talk, y'all, man. I'm going to get on the show. I was on the wrong route. Shit, I'm all over there. I was supposed to have been over here.
Oh, you got over here.
You know, Green Line. This green line over here. High.
Green Line?
White Castle's, you know, high. White number, Castle's at on Green Line.
That's number two.
That's number 16.
That's Parsons.
You know what? White, you know what I'm talking about? High and Green Line.
Oh, Park, don't listen to me. I have your ass going.
You know what I'm talking about? High and Green Line?
Up to the.
Is that White Castle out there?
Yeah.
Number 16.
And Long John Silver's across the street somewhere?
That's way down. Yeah, that's way down.
It's only like a 15-minute walk. You're going way longer on the bus.
You know, Sapphire? Sapphire?
Yeah.
You're going
16.
Yeah, it is 16.
Oh, 16?
It's like
a 15-minute walk.
Shit. I'm on the wrong end of the street. I didn't miss my shit.
Well, the Most High wanted to mark you. That's why he brought you here.
Yeah.
Now, the Most High said put a mark on the foreheads of those that signed that cry. And the ones, you know, there's another mark
over
also.
Here. Right. Got you back over here.
So what's your nationality?
Himself.
Let me answer that again. That be me, baby. My name's Ivory, man. I'm the only soap, you know, spell the same way that...
What's your name?
The only soap that flows. Ivory.
Ivory. Ivory.
Ivory.
Ivory.
Ivory.
Ivory.
Ivory.
Ivory.
The only soap that flows, baby.
Only soul that
float. Trust me, you ain't gonna see no other soul float.
I heard that.
Woo wee. Is that a parable? Is that a parable?
That's two-third parable, man.
That's some of that wisdom.
Hey, we might as well stay on this for a minute, man, because I'm gonna read the definition of Egypt in the book in the dictionary.
That's good.
It just proves the point that Israel and Ham is different, separate again. Country northeast of Africa, also called country of Ham. Watered by the Nile, the longest river in the world, 4,000 miles, an annual overflow of which are the greatest importance of the country because of almost complete absence of rain. Country divided into Upper and Lower Egypt. Lower Egypt included the Delta area, now valley and delta bound by desert, called Mizraim by the Israelites. Ruler called Pharaoh, religious polytheistic gods. That was it on there. Like polite and all them motherfuckers. So they are Israelites, Jakes. I ain't gonna say Israelite, they Jakes. You know? Claiming that Israel, that Egypt bullshit.
That Egypt shit's retarded.
That Egypt bullshit.
Yeah, I mean, how many times you gotta go over that shit? The ancient Egyptians were retarded as hell. They worshiped cats, bulls.
Hell, they fucked alligators.
They had sex with alligators.
Can you imagine that though? A crocodile? They turned that motherfucker over and mounting.
Oh,
an alligator, man.
And then all the pharaohs married their biological sister. And they got DNA tests to prove it.
Yeah,
because they got mummies. They left evidence.
Yeah, they digging into King Tut's shit now. And they say they found some so-called shocking evidence they about to release.
Because they say King Tut's father was Akhenaten, and his mother was Nefertiti, right? And they was, or something like that.
Can you hold this for a second?
Nefertiti.
What was I about to say? Because a lot of people say they have skulls of ancient Egyptians, like the pharaohs, and they'll have elongated heads, their skulls are misshaped and stuff.
Right.
And people say, see, that means they're aliens. No, what actually is a genetic disorder as a result from inbreeding. Because the same thing happened to the Incas. Because, you know, the Inca royal family, even though they was Israelites, but they was heathens in a heathen state of mind. The royal families married their brother and sister.
That's foul.
And they had all kind of genetic disorders because of that. Because they had elongated heads, too.
Right.
I mean, that's real. I mean, we can't make that shit up.
Yeah, check this out, bro. This is an example of
even Esau, the elite families that control the earth, they fucked their sisters too. Just like your boy Caligula. He wanted to run to Egypt so he could marry his sister.
Yeah, he lost his mind when she died.
Oh, yeah. Caligula. The greatest of all the Roman Caesars.
I wish I could put this on camera, but this is a result of cross inbreeding. This is the royal family, too. This is the royal family.
The Habsburg jaw?
Yeah, that's the royal family. See, he looks just like the queen.
Get him on camera.
You know, looks just like the queen. But I can't remember her name. I think one of them's named Catherine. Her name is Catherine. She's still alive, but that one died.
They look all fucked up.
Yeah, that's inbred. These are the families. They don't put them away. They put them in institutions where they're taken care of, you know?
Because, the same thing happened with the Kennedys, didn't they? Had the one retarded kid. They had to give a lobotomy.
Right. Oh, shit. I forgot about him. I can't remember. I got to look his name up real quick. He's part of their family, too. That's Jack the Ripper.
Oh, okay.
He was a crazy retard from their royal family. Everybody heard of Jack the
Google
Ripper.
Yeah, Google search?
Yeah.
At Google,
yeah.
A Habsburg jaw. Let me look it up for you. Yeah, because one thing about the elite is they don't like to mingle their blood with the peasants because they believe they have superior genetics, and they got to keep all the money in the family too. They don't want none of their wealth to get in the hands of the common folk, so they marry family, they inbreed. What do you think the ancient Egyptians did? They was inbreeders.
I'm just going to use my stuff. I'm not going to use Wi-Fi. I'm going to cut this Wi-Fi off so my shit can work faster. This is on the
Verizon. I'm going to get a scripture on that. What's that? Leviticus 19, I think. It's been a minute since I looked it up. Let's see if I can find it.
Here you go. This one.
All I got to do is search on Habsburg jaw. You guys want to crack up when you see this
one. Goddamn inbred. And they do it with their first brother and sister. They don't even wait till, you know.
This is some funny shit. Now, this is an Esau's genetic disorder right here.
Right.
Check this shit out. Get this on camera. Is it coming?
I don't know why it does that, man. I can't figure that shit out.
It's freezing up.
Go through it.
Oh, here it goes. Look. It's the Habsburg jaw. You can see every dirt shit's all fucked up. See, they get the underbite.
It's like a bull mastiff again.
Wrong turn.
Look at that. You see the jaw? See, there you go. No, that's not it. How do we get back to the...
I gotta figure that out why it's like that, man. I don't know why it does that.
Shit's all... Yeah, fuck it.
I think it's opposite when you go through Google, but when you...
All right, here, we'll do this. Go to Yandex.
See, there's two-thirds wisdom. They throw them down right now. They converse, you know. They enlightening each other.
Yeah, they over there proselytizing. You know what I'm saying? Talking about, yeah, we're going to fuck that bitch together. We're going to tag team that hoe.
That's the same nigga we was talking to, too.
Black bitch. I got a preset. Oh.
Go ahead, bring it up.
It's Jeremiah 8 and 5. When then... Why then is this people of Jerusalem slidden back by perpetual backsliding? They hold fast the seat. They refuse to return.
That's our people. They refuse. They ain't going to return to the Lord.
Even after giving them the beautiful truth, man.
The truth ain't for everybody anyway. Right.
The amazing truth, man.
All right, here we go. I don't know if you can get that on camera. But you can see the Habsburg jaw. He said, their shits are, look how weird they look.
That's a bull mastiff.
That's all from inbreeding.
Yeah.
Cause that's the hat. Look at this thing right here.
Wow.
That's
now that's
boy.
Some retarded shit.
Hey, we seen that guy, the reincarnation out on campus.
Remember that dude John Emway?
They got an elongated head.
Yeah,
cause see that, cause the elongated head. That's, you know, go back to the Egyptians. They's inbreeders. But you can see that,
yeah,
man.
But the funny thing about the elongated head. A lot of them were the baby come Jay out. You know, when the baby come out, the head is soft.
Jay
and they was actually molding some of them to resemble the kings.
Because they was trying to mimic. They didn't realize that was a genetic disorder.
Right.
They was trying to mimic some
mimic
people.
The king, the higher up.
Yeah.
Six,
So yeah, go research that, man.
Because the Habsburg, I gotta say this.
Because the Habsburg, they controlled half of Europe. You know what I mean? And they all inbred. Right. But we know the average person ain't got a clue about what's going on. They don't know nothing about the history of the Earth. They don't know. They don't know the history of America. I bet they couldn't even tell you what July 4th represents. I mean, really, that's how dumb they are. They don't know basic history. All they know is bullshit knowledge. They know the history of the NFL. You know what I'm saying? They know the history of the NBA. That's it.
It's March Madness time.
Yeah, March Madness. They got that right. Madness.
Madness.
That's madness.
That's some more of this, dude.
Go ahead.
It's verse Jeremiah 8:6. I hearkened and heard, but they spake not aright. No man repented him of his wickedness, saying, what have I done? Everyone turned to his own course. Like this dude said, he's himself, whatever.
There you go. You said that, didn't you? Show him out, didn't he?
Yeah, he said, I'm me.
So up, only soap that float.
What's up, bro?
What's up?
Hey.
Prophesying the destruction of America.
Paving the way for the Lord. He's on his way.
Lord, you see all these buildings?
He's at hand.
Soon they're going to be turned into a pallet of dust. They're going to be turned into ashes. It's just going to be burned up.
That's right. And it's, hey, that's scripture. You read the Bible before, haven't you?
Hey, let's get it.
Your family's read the Bible, you know? You never read it? Straight up. Well, you know what? You probably Jake too, anyway.
Oh, yeah.
You a brother. You ain't nothing but a black man.
An Israelite.
You a black man. You just a light-skinned black man.
Yeah, you light-skinned.
Right. That's all. You a black man, so this pertains to you. You know? You a man. You an Israelite. That's you. You're not a white man. You know? You're not a white man. That's not your nationality. A white man.
The white man is a devil.
Right. And you're not an American either.
Yeah, American.
Right. You're not. Your forefathers don't come out of America. What's his name? Americo Vespucci?
Yeah.
Your forefathers don't come. His forefathers. None
hell
of our forefathers come through them devils, man. We're all the same people. All of us the same people, man. We're Israelites. So we're paving the way for the Lord. Putting it in your head before he gets here. So you won't have no excuse. Oh, I didn't know. So when he gets here, it's going to be death and destruction. He's probably just telling you that these bills are about to come down. We're about to get this in the scripture.
Hey, let me get it real quick. Amos 9:8. Behold, the eyes of the Lord God are upon the sinful kingdom, and I will destroy it from off the face of the earth, saving that I will not utterly destroy the house of Jacob, save the Lord. That's right, the house of Jacob. Jacob, you know who Jacob is? Jacob is the forefather of the 12 tribes of Israel. See, Jacob, his name was changed to Israel. And the Lord, he wrestled with an angel, and the Lord said, your name is no more Jacob, now your name's Israel, which means he is a prince of God, okay?
I got something wrong.
I'll go ahead.
This is 2 Peter 3:9. Oh, I'm going to start at 7, bro. But the heavens and the earth, which are now by the same word, are kept in store, reserved unto fire.
To fire.
Against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men.
That's all you see out here, ungodly men.
But, beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing, that one day is with the Lord as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as one day.
Yeah, because people are like, well, the Lord, he gonna come back. He's supposed to been back. You know, but the Lord, according to the Bible, the Lord only came here 2 days ago.
Imagine that.
The one they call Jesus walked on the earth 2,000 years ago.
That's right.
But it said the day, one day to the Lord is like 1,000 years.
So he died 2,000 years ago, right? It's 2 days. 2 days ago to him.
You know,
so imagine if something happened to you 2 days ago. Somebody robbed you, killed your family, cut you all up, and then hung you on the cross. How you going to feel 2 days from now?
Oh, you ain't going to forget that.
You ain't going to ride. You're going to be thinking in your mind revenge.
Oh, man.
And that's all through the scriptures that the Lord is coming back.
Let me get a preset, one.
This is fire.
I'll go ahead. I'll get a preset right now.
Listen, the Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering to us, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night. That sounds horrible itself.
It's like you, when you least suspect it. Evil come when you least suspect it.
Right. Now, we're in the age of technology, right? The Lord is not sending no emails out. Well, you ain't getting no texts because everybody got Obama phones.
They got him on Twitter. All the Lord's
right, talking. Twitter, right. Will come as a thief in the night, and the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise. Those are missiles going off. Boom!
Yeah, because you know, noise. Yeah, and the missiles is mainly going to be coming from Russia.
Russia got some.
They got more, Russia has more nuclear missiles than the rest of the world combined.
Woo! It's beautiful, man.
They're all going to get spent. Every last one of them getting fired, getting shot.
Right.
They didn't spend all that money on those missiles just to put them in a missile museum.
You know what I'm saying? Or dismantle them one day.
Yeah, and just dismantle them. Like,
right.
You know, they're going to use those missiles.
They made them to use them. Listen. Like the brother was on when he first walked up. And the elements shall melt with fervent heat.
Yeah, how do you melt the elements with fervent heat? Through those missiles. That's the only thing. It will melt everything.
The earth also and the works that are therein shall be burned up. Speaks for itself.
It speaks for itself.
Speaks for itself.
The scriptures talk about this great fire that's coming over. And over and over. It's all
beautiful, man.
From Genesis all the way to Revelation, it constantly talks about the last days when that fire is going to come.
Right.
Now, look, I got a scripture. He said how the Lord's going to get revenge when he comes back, right? Revelation 1:7. Behold, he cometh with clouds, and every eye shall see him, and all they also which pierced him.
Them clouds. Now, them clouds ain't no rain cloud that's going to be dropping rain.
That's those so-called UFOs.
That's right.
Because the Lord,
that's right.
You see them so-called UFOs, that's the Lord flying around the angels. But look, it said, behold, he cometh with clouds, and every eye shall see him.
Every eye.
And they also which pierced him, which was the Romans, which is Esau, and all kindreds of the earth shall wail because of him. Even so, amen. But the churches teach that Jesus love everybody. He love everybody, but he gonna make them wail.
Right. He's gonna cut up a few people, but he loves.
Like, see the sign off the building right there?
Yeah, that looks pretty tripped out, don't it?
Oh, that's bad. That's bad, man.
I always like seeing that. Hopefully that next light reflection is that cloud.
The cloud back that way.
Yeah.
But that's what's coming, though. Death and destruction.
You know, a lot of people have dreams about the nukes. You know, you might have a dream. You see a nuclear destruction. You wake up. Oh, shit. That's the Lord giving you a vision.
You have visions of riots, of madness going on. You know?
Like right now. Like,
yeah, exactly, man.
What church are you guys?
This is it. This is church right here. This is church.
I got a scripture for that.
You know, this is the Lord didn't tell the apostles, the elect, to go to go to some good. We can hook you up.
Yeah, we got a Twitter account and stuff.
Right.
YouTube. I mean, you get on Twitter.
Do you have like a card or something?
YouTube.
Nah, we can just give you a
YouTube channel.
Phone numbers if you need that.
Oh yeah, you can do that.
Because it's really for him. It's really for me. No disrespect to no. I don't.
The man's
know
supposed to teach the woman.
Exactly.
That's the proper order, the way the Lord has set it up.
Right. But he wants to join, so.
Well, you know, he's going to have to learn.
He wants to learn.
To come into wisdom, to come into the Lord's house, man, this takes discipline to sit at home and you really read and study, and, you know. You just can't be just listening to brothers give you information and that's it. You got to do your own thing.
I mean, you got to be sincere, that's all it
right.
is.
Sincere, really.
So, everything is really about sincerity.
Humbling yourself.
Yep.
You know, because ain't nothing to be ashamed not knowing something, man.
Yeah.
Ain't nothing, because we was retarded as hell before the Lord woke us up. You know?
And we still retarded concerning certain things. And because the Bible said that even the Lord's foolishness is wiser than the wisdom of men.
I might as well get it.
Is that true down there? It said that the Jews were sucking blood from the babies.
Yeah.
We got pictures of it.
That's a picture right there.
We got pictures of it.
And they're the ones that own, they own downtown. Robert Weiler's name was on almost all these buildings. He's a so-called Jew. Well, they're ready for that, ain't it?
That's cool.
Hey, there's some humble people, though.
Hey, some gonna be saved.
Yep.
And most gonna get burnt the fuck up. Now, you only see two individuals right here listening. When, look,
Yeah. You don't give a damn about the Lord's word, man. Hell no. That's why the Lord said when he come and y'all call, I bet you they
gonna throw some money in the offering plate.
Right.
To pastor cocaine, pastor pork chop.
I'm gonna read this for the edifying of other cameras since they gonna be checking out the thing. Cause that's
some deep information.
They're getting programmed right now, especially him.
They reading all that, yeah. That's going right to the mind.
That's right. For this is 1 Corinthians 1:18. For the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness.
To them.
But unto us which are saved, it is the power of the Most High Yahweh, for Hashem Yahweh Shah. For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise and will bring to nothing the understanding of the prudent. Where is the wise? Where is the scribe? Where is the disputers of this world? Have not the Most High made foolish the wisdom of this world?
Yeah, because there ain't no wisdom out here. It's all foolishness.
For after that, in the wisdom of the Most High, the world by wisdom knew not the Most High. It pleased the Most High by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe.
Yeah. And also, like I said, it said, where are the disputers of this world? You supposed to come out here and dispute this world. You know what I mean? Because this ain't, we ain't living in Candy Land. You know what I'm saying? This shit is, we live, it's the most evil, corrupt, wicked nation in the face of the earth. You supposed to come out here and dispute this world. You know, expose all the wickedness that you see.
They don't give a fuck, man. They don't give a fuck.
Yeah, I mean, they poor as hell. Got no money.
Curses.
You know what I'm saying? Probably half of them, you know, almost a week away from being homeless.
They're already homeless.
and still, they wonder why they in the conditions they in.
Right. You know what I mean? Like the scripture says, cursed shall you be when you come in. Cursed shall you shall be when you go out.
Yeah.
You know? And this is the answer. So this is the answer for them. But
some of the answers, you know, I'm going to get my mixtape, you know what I'm saying?
Answers
get these
mama.
Raps, you know what I'm saying? Yes, I got bars, son. I got bars. That's their knowledge, that they got bars.
Here you go. You keep reading this. For the Jews require a sign, and the Greeks seek after wisdom. But we preached Yahweh Shai crucified, unto the Jews a stumbling block, and unto the Greeks foolishness. But unto them which are called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ the power of the Most High and the wisdom of God, because the foolishness of the Most High is wiser than men, and the weakness of the Most High is stronger than men. For ye see your calling, brethren, how that not many wise men after the flesh, not many mighty, not many noble are called. But the Most High hath chosen the foolish things of the world to confound the wise. And the Most High hath chosen the weak things of the world to confound the things that are mighty. That's why we downtown. Right across the street from the town, the state house or whatever the fuck that building is called.
The temple.
Police station down there.
The state house, that's just the temple of Jupiter.
Right.
That's a pagan temple. All kind of wickedness goes on inside the state house. And right, what's the city hall right down the street?
That's right, we in the midst of it all. We right there in the center.
There's all kind of witchcraft going on out here.
Oh, let me get the pistol. We're gonna prophesy again to many kings. I love that scripture because it's reincarnation.
Read this.
Yeah. I love that scripture. Right now. Okay, here we go.
They still bugging out over that juice on.
Waking up to our enemy, man. Yeah, that's the time of awakening.
That's the number one enemy, too.
That's the root of problems, man. That's the head of the snake.
The head of the snake.
The viper. The viper's head.
Yeah, right. That is the head.
They're waking up to it, man.
That house of Amalek.
Yeah. Chaos break down, man. The peace. These people gonna go after these privileged. They're privileged.
And you see, Amalek is so proud that he thinks that he can hide right in the midst of Jake. Right, you see, like, yeah, you got Bexley's, the number one juice spot, right? And it's surrounded by Jakes all around them. And they think they can just be safe like that forever. That's a proud spirit, man.
That's right. Slick, man. They think they slick.
They are slick. That's the most slimiest slithering serpent on the face of the earth. Just slithering all over the place.
Got it called out, though.
Yeah.
We the elect. That's how, you know. Yeah. It's only the elect that's doing that.
And they hate it when they see us out here, too, man. They just want to kill us. A rabbi would not be spraying this
Wait till we read Revelations for them if they don't believe.
Right there in the front.
Oh, shit. It is.
They're going over there deep in that. They're having a little conversation about it.
That's cool. I got to bring it. Master King of those. Even not for
I'll bring that up.
The Zuma from the Jews hide in the midst of Jacob so they can claim their Jacob.
Well, and that, so they can claim their Jacob at the same time. If you want slaves to do work for you, you can't live 1,000 miles away from them. They got to be right there with you.
Right.
You know what I mean? Who you think serves them in all the restaurants and all the anything they do, they got Jake's being their servants. Soon the tables are going to be turned and they're going to go into slavery.
I can't stand a stupid nigga.
Oh, that's why people don't know that during the transatlantic slave trade, the so-called Jews, they was the number one financiers of the slave trade. Who do you think owned all the slave ships? So-called Jews. That's a fact.
That's right.
That's a fact.
That's right. That's
pretty sad. But no, nobody know that. They don't know that. They don't know nothing.
This is Wisdom of Solomon 6:5. Horribly and speedily shall he come upon you, for a sharp judgment shall be to them that be in high places. For mercy will soon pardon the meanest, but mighty men shall be mightily tormented.
Mm. Yep, mightily. They go, that's good. That torment is going to be beautiful, man.
That's right.
We're going to praise the Most High on that day.
Keep going. For he which is Lord over all shall fear no man's person, neither shall he stand in awe of any man's greatness, for he hath made the small and great and cared for all alike. But a sore trial shall come upon the mighty.
What that say?
But a sore trial shall come upon the mighty.
A sour trial, that's right. That cup is gonna shift off of us onto them. You know? That's karma. Shit, that's karma.
Reap what you sow.
That's right. That's how you gonna do evil and wickedness to a people that's done nothing to you, that's bothered, that ain't bothering you, but you gonna go and just whoop their ass, destroy them, mentally and physically.
That was a good point 2 days ago. That's a real good point.
What's that? That
2 days ago thing.
Yeah. Oh yeah, 2,000 years ago.
So, yeah,
actually, we're in the beginning of the third day.
Yeah. Really? Yeah.
We're in the beginning of the third day. Like the Lord was raised on the third day, right? That's some spiritual stuff. That's just spiritual.
Fresh.
That's just spiritual. You know?
We're going into that new age. You know what I'm saying?
Age of Aquarius.
Oh, yeah. They try to call it that.
Right.
It's the age of the Lord.
Right.
The age of the kingdom of heaven.
That's right. Look, let's look at everybody that get on there. That didn't have no time.
Woe unto the wicked on YouTube. Huh? Woe unto the wicked. Woe unto the wicked. Or look up on Twitter.
W-O-E.
Kings of the Earth is easy to remember, right? Kings of the Earth on Twitter. That's easy to remember. All one word.
Oh,
if he can give you a number real quick. Hold him up real quick.
Wait.
Oh, he got you. So, yeah, man, you can call it, you know what I'm saying, anytime.
Lord, texting you, man.
Hold on. Tell him, wait a second. Get some.
Stall. Get 1 foot in and 1 foot out.
Yeah, there you go. You can just get him like that.
Hold him up.
Check my DNA.
It's going to be a red light anyway.
Let's go.
My hand's cold.
What?
Huh?
Oh,
okay, cool. I can ride a slipper today.
Sorry.
That's all good.
Yeah, because usually the buses come down here and line up, you know?
Yeah, he said it's 753.
He's just moving down so the other buses can get.
What time
is it?
Shit, almost 8 o'clock.
Yeah, that's your bus.
Oh, shit, hurry up,
buddy.
About 10 minutes.
Exactly. What side of town y'all stay on?
For us, because they don't expire until 7:53. Hurry up. Who's on there?
What side of town y'all at? From out in the east, I live in Whitehall.
Well, so we're running
out of the south. Okay, that's right down the street from.
Yeah, we're right behind it. All of you guys
out. Okay, man.
All right. Oh, that is number two. Yeah, number two, go all the way out east, done.
There goes the Reynoldsburg.
Yeah. Fuck Reynoldsburg. Fuck all. I hate all them little ass towns, man. Reynoldsburg and Hannah's the worst.
Birds been circling.
They start going, hopefully they start shitting on people.
Crows.
Look, the birds, they got more freedom than us. You know what I mean?
Like, that's why Lynyrd Skynyrd made that song, Free Bird.
Oh yeah, Free Bird is the best song ever.
It's a song one that says, if I had wings, I'd fly away as a bird or something like that.
There's a lot of songs like that. Well, the Lord said the birds have their nests and the foxes have their holes. But the Son of Man have nowhere to lay his head.
And it don't work. But they
that's
still
brotherly love for you right there. A brother, the Lord ain't got nowhere to lay his head.
And what's that one scripture? Let's get that.
That's some wicked shit, man. So long. Brother, they don't want to show no love for you, man. I hate a motherfucker like that.
Yeah.
The Lord hate him too.
Oh, that you talking about somebody would call that dude a cracker or something?
No, I'm talking about just brotherly love.
Oh, yeah. Like, well, that's
I was just talking about the scripture for you.
Oh, I was thinking about foul. Hold on, I'm gonna find a good scripture.
Oh, you're talking about the birds, though.
No, it's a different one. The one where he said,
That's why there's many of us. We all think different, but we all think the same.
But it's Matthew 11.
You know, one of brothers see some another way, because that's how the Lord's word can go. It can go either, you know.
That's why you can't come out.
Water. A river have branches that break, yeah. You know.
There goes right. Uncle Kurt.
Yeah, even the Nile, that great river, it turns into all kind of rivers. But it all comes from the same source.
It's not no stagnant water.
No, is that or is that Mark 11? I think it's Mark 11. It's been so long since I got this scripture. I think it's Mark 11. What's that one when it said the birds, the flowers toil not?
Matthew 6.
Is it Matthew
6?
All Christmas.
All Christmas number.
That's how I remember that one. Right.
Is it Matthew 6? You sure?
Yeah,
I know he bothered. He remembers stuff better than me.
You know, Christmas, that's the only section they get. Matthew 5, 6, and 7. That's
Matthew. They don't even get all the 5. They'll skip the part about the law.
Yeah.
You know, they don't want to read that part. Oh, here it is. Yeah, you're right. He's on point, man. That's why you gotta have brothers with you teach them.
That's right.
Because I think it is in Mark, too. It's in Matthew, let's start at Matthew 6 and 24. No man can serve two masters, for he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. Mm. You cannot serve God and mammon. So that goes back, who's your master? Our master's the Most High. So that's why we don't give a damn about no politicians, no Barack Obama, no Donald Trump, none of this dumbass shit.
Some March Madness shit.
Yeah, some March Madness. Therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what ye shall eat or what ye shall drink, nor yet for your body what ye shall put on. Is not the life more than meat, and the body than raiment? Because that's all this world is about. That's all they think about, is stocking up more money, working and working, getting more and more and more, taking more, raping the earth. It says, behold, the fowls of the air, for they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are ye not much better than they? I mean, that's a good point right there. Like, the birds, they living free. They ain't out here on the grind. You see people's Facebook pages. I'm on the grind. You know what I'm saying? Get my grind on.
About to get it.
Life ain't good.
I heard that the other day. It vexed the shit out of me, man. But I started laughing, though.
That's that deep parable.
Hey, put me on there. 2 phones.
Y'all got 2 phones, too, huh? Y'all get 2 missiles apiece. 2 missiles.
After the first one hits, you get another one.
A faggot.
Right.
Retard, man.
Just for reinsurance.
Hey, the Lord ain't singing 2 phones. He got 2 goddamn cell phones.
Yeah, the Lord got 2 swords to chop off your head.
And he got 2 missiles for you.
Yeah, a double-edged sword. He got a double-edged sword.
Double-edged sword.
That's what the Lord got.
That's right.
No goddamn 2 phones.
2 phones.
I ain't hear that bullshit.
I got 2 phones.
The Lord ain't trying to hear your bullshit music, all right?
Here you go. 1 Corinthians 10 and 20. But I say that the things which the Gentiles sacrifice, they sacrifice to devils and not to the Most High. and I would not that ye should have fellowship with devils. Ye cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of devils.
That goes hand in hand with, I'm a man of the Lord, but yeah, you singing two phones. But that really goes into, look at all these, what this really is talking about, you look at these churches. All these churches, they celebrate pagan holidays like Christmas and Easter. We got Easter coming up. Easter, a pagan holiday. That's a practice. Show me, they know where no Easter up in the Bible. That goes back to worshiping that, the fertility goddess.
Some Easter eggs.
Some Easter eggs.
Oh, ain't that this week?
And they make
it's coming up though.
They make children go out on Easter egg hunts and color eggs. But don't you know the origin of coloring Easter eggs go back to the high priest of Satan dipping Easter eggs in the blood of sacrificed children? That's a fact. That's a fact.
Hey, the church got them doing this too.
The church do. The church have Halloween parties where they dress up like devils and witches.
That's right.
So the Lord gonna burn all these churches to the ground.
That's right.
And then we gonna laugh and we gonna celebrate.
1 Corinthians 10:21. Ye cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of devils.
Yeah, the Lord's gonna shut all everything down. Okay. He's gonna burn the preacher up. He gonna burn up the congregation. Anybody going against the word of the Most High getting burned up.
That's right.
That's all there is to it.
You cannot be partakers of the Lord's table and of the table of devils.
Yep. America is the table of devils. America is the kingdom of Satan. Satan sits on his throne in America. The Church of Satan was founded in America, in San Francisco. It's perfectly legal to worship Satan. In America, they say it's legal for a man to marry a man.
Woo!
So you're gonna tell me?
Man, it's a line two. Line two is across the street.
Oh, that's over there, number two again. That's like that. It's not like the prison roundup or something. It's you know what I mean? Get the slave ships ready. Look at this. Madness, man. Show them the lineup. Maybe they don't know what the lineup looks like. It's like that. Raggedy ass Coda bus. Cost $2 to ride a Coda bus. Yeah, $2 one way. One way. I mean, these people got no money and they charge ridiculous prices to get on a bus. $2 for goddamn devils, man. And the price don't fluctuate with gas prices either. That makes too much sense. It's all a scam, man. Everything in this country is designed to keep you poor. You know what I'm saying? You get a job, you get paid what? You lucky if you make $10 an hour, but then you gotta buy a car, thousands of dollars. To get to work, you need a car, you gotta pay $4 a day to get to work, a Coda bus. Then on top of that, if you got a car, you gotta get tags, that costs money. And then you gotta get a license, that costs money. Gas costs a whole lot of money. And then you gotta get insurance. And if you don't get insurance, then they gonna take your license away and you get caught without a license, then you're fucked in the ass. So it's all a big scam. Yeah. To make sure that you stay poor and you stay down and you don't get back up. Fucking baggage.
There you go, 20, I'm still jump to 24. Let no man seek his own, but every man another's wealth. Whatsoever is sold into shambles, that eat, asking no question for conscience sake. For the earth is of the Lord and the fullness thereof. If any of them that believe not bid you to a feast, and ye be disposed to go, whatsoever is set before you, eat, asking no question for conscience sake. But if any man say unto you, this is offered in sacrifice unto idols, eat not for his sake that showed it, and for conscience sake, for the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. Conscience, I say, not thine own, but of the other. For why is my liberty judged of another man's conscience? For if I by grace be a partaker, why am I evil spoken of for that for which I give thanks? Whether therefore ye eat or drink or whatsoever ye do, do all to the glory of the Most High. I was just reading that for the what you're saying, how just not partaking in this evil shit. Yeah. You see somebody else doing evil and getting paid. Don't you? I mean, that's what the enticing.
Then you got our people. Then our people they fight over to get jobs working for this devil to help enslave their own people.
They will
work and fight to enslave themselves to make no massive.
Foolish people.
We gonna stay slaves forever.
Foolish people. trusted oppression.
Like, who works at the B&B? None but Israel. Our people.
That's Israel.
Mostly so-called black ones.
Israel.
And they give you a hard way to go, too.
No, go down to child support.
Child support.
That's who mainly works in there is black bitches, man.
That's their main one they get.
Main
the, what they call them? The old Aunt Jemima bitches. The bitches.
Mammies.
Yeah, the mammies. That's what they call them, mammies?
Yeah,
mammies.
I call them bitches.
Dirty hoes.
Just dirt. Right. Look at these sodomites.
Some motherfucking fried chicken eating bitches.
That's what I call them too, bitches and hoes.
Fried pork chop eating bitches. Nasty bitches.
That's all these whores are, is nasty ass bitches.
Appreciate it though. This is Sirach 9-11. Envy not the glory of a sinner, for thou knowest not. Envy not the glory of a sinner, for thou knowest not what shall be his end.
All right, yeah, because people always, they want to, oh, like people, they used to envy Tupac. Oh, I want to be just like Tupac. Look what happened to Tupac. He got shot in his goddamn head. But they all want to be like Biggie Smalls. I don't know who would want to be like that fat bastard. But look what happened to that fat piece of shit.
Right, you listen to him talk, after he finished talking, he can't even breathe.
Right.
Right. Fat man. Got all that money and got fatter, man.
Can't just spend all his money on food.
Having pig roast every day.
Shit. He got everything.
Yeah, you know he was, man.
Just stinking up the place, too. You know he smelled. Just stinking. And the bitch was just fighting in line to fuck that nasty.
Yeah. And they thinking they mom getting a paycheck.
Yeah. That nasty motherfucker. He had a song on the Ready to Die where he was talking about a bitch. He was letting bitches shit on him.
Oh, goodness.
That's a nasty motherfucker.
I got to hear that nasty shit.
You remember that? I'm Ready to Die.
I never listened to
you
it.
Bumped that.
You never listened to Biggie?
I ain't never listened to Biggie.
Just like that song, Me and My Bitch.
I hate it, Biggie.
He said,
yeah, I do too.
And that song, Me and My Bitch, he was talking about, he said, she looks so good, I suck on her daddy's dick.
Back in those days, I hated rap music, period.
No, I love Ready to Die. I still got the whole album memorized. I done listened to it a billion times.
I remember one time.
That used to be my wisdom, was give me the loot. That was my proverbs was
I was happy as fuck when Tupac got shot.
Yeah, it was some bugged out shit though. I wasn't happy though, that was my daughter. But it was bugged out.
I hated him back then. Right.
Tupac,
I didn't like him till like 2000.
I always had a fascination with Tupac.
Oh yeah, listen to that shit now, it's garbage.
Wicked ass shit, man. It's just wicked as fuck.
But still, motherfuckers listening to 2 Chainz and Kevin Gates.
Yeah, Tupac sound like a fucking, that sounds like Beethoven compared to that shit.
What?
That's, you know what I mean?
Beethoven's shit.
Yeah. Beethoven's awesome.
Yeah.
What I'm saying, Tupac is like a fucking musical genius compared to 2 Chainz.
Beethoven's beautiful.
You know what I mean?
I got some more of this. Delight not in the thing that the ungodly have pleasure in, but remember, they shall not go unpunished into their grave.
There you go.
Yeah, so, yeah, right. So you don't be envying all these famous people. A lot of these famous people, I wish I was just like them. And then they get caught with a tranny. Or you could be like Bill Cosby, you get caught up with all kinds of scandals.
They overdose on their tour bus.
They overdose.
Right.
Or the so-called Jew would kill him, say it was a drug overdose and take all the money. I mean, it's just, it always ends badly for these famous people.
Right, here you go. This is Ecclesiastes 14:3. Riches are not comely for a nigger.
There you go.
And what should an envious man do with money?
Exactly.
You know?
That sums it up perfectly.
The same envious motherfucker that's broke as fuck, looking at everybody that got something, that worked hard to get it, give that motherfucker some money and watch what he do with it. You know?
How you gonna waste it?
He already rich from whatever lottery or whatever he won. He'll still go out and buy like a shipload of cocaine.
He'll just buy a bunch of dumb ass shit.
Dumb shit. Open there be studios. What was that?
It was like that Dave Chappelle.
Franchise at KFC.
When black folks got their reparations.
Escalades have officially sold out.
A record number of studios.
This just in. FUBU and KFC has merged.
Yeah, because he had your one boy, Ashy Larry, pulled up. It's like, he had a whole semi-truck full of cigarettes.
Newport.
He's like, I got enough cigarettes to last me and my family the rest of our life.
I mean, can you imagine it, though?
Jake,
can you imagine it, though?
That's how Jake, he just blows the money.
There'd be cookouts everywhere.
That was the most realistic shit ever.
It really is.
I gotta go watch that shit now.
So I can't even go where they
were. Right. Like the main one, they would all open up recording studios.
That's the main thing. my cousin,
Jake loves
my cousin's daughter, her husband, won so many millions from getting raped from a pastor, right? This is a true story. And I put my kid's life on it, man. This dude went and opened a studio, man. And went and opened a music studio, man. I'm not making it up, man.
I believe it.
I swear to God, I swear, man. I'm not lying, man. He went and opened a music studio, and it was the worst music next to my cousin's music
that worse
I've
than
ever
Dave's?
Heard in my life, man. Worse than Dave's, man. It was worse than Dave's, man.
Even Dave's?
It was. It was worse than Dave's. Can you imagine somebody with no intelligence that's never been out the hood?
So what you gonna do, Dave, watch this video now?
Oh, like, yeah, we told him that shit was terrible.
Yeah, right.
We let him know.
We let him know. You know, but yeah, he was worse than Dave. Far worse than Dave, man. But
how is that possible?
You imagine this dude bought expensive studio equipment and everything, got the house done, so the like the sounds in, so the sounds will bounce around and echoes. And,
yeah.
You know, there's a science behind the studio.
There is.
You know, and nothing was still done right. Nothing was, man. But yeah, he was getting raped by the pastor. Man.
He was probably sucking cock afterwards.
You can tell when you see me a faggot. Now he broke. Now they flat broke.
Yeah, these people, they will suck a dick to get famous. People, I've heard people say, I'm like, I be trying to teach people, like, don't you know, to get famous, you want to suck a dick.
Woo!
He's like, just one dick? No big deal. You know, that's how they really
that's
looking at
hell,
it.
Man.
You
see,
it's
I
just
know,
one.
I know.
They
I know.
They think it's just one quick suck. I can just suck it and get.
That simple. Yeah. It ain't that simple.
They really think that.
Your soul's destroyed after that.
You see that meme that says, I'm not, it has a homeless dude wearing his shirt, it says, I'm not gay, but $20 is $20.
Damn.
Nah, people really think like that, man.
They do. And that's two-thirds.
Just like these bitches, they think they're just, I can make a quick, you know, a few thousand off this porno real quick, and then her husband will let her do it just so they can, you know, pay the rent.
And that's a foul motherfucker to let her do.
Oh, they got a documentary on Netflix about bitches going out to fucking Florida doing these porns, and they're only good for 3 videos.
Right. Here you go. This is Ecclesiastes 26:8. A drunken woman in a gabber of brawl causes great anger, and she will not cover her own shame. The whoredom of a woman may be known in her haughty looks and eyelids. If thy daughters be shameless, keep her in straight.
If your daughters be shameless, meaning, you know, she walking around wearing them, wearing those pink shorts. You know what I'm talking about. They say pink on them. And you can see her pussy. And,
The pink is right on
the ass. Yeah, it says pink on it.
It says love
pink. Or they're wearing the tight-ass black pants with the, you know, the whore outfit. The
Eskimo
black pants
boots.
With the boots. Right. The Eskimo boots with
the
black.
Camel toes in.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. The yoga pants.
Say, yoga pants. Yeah.
So if you're watching this and your daughter wears that, she's a whore.
Yeah.
Shorts.
Yeah, she's a whore.
That's right, she's a whore.
Your daughter's a fucking whore.
Mama too. I see grandmamas wearing.
Yep. And they look
nasty. I see grandmamas wearing.
You see these fat bitches out wearing that shit, man. Yep.
Hold on, I gotta bring this up.
They look good too.
I gotta say this. This dude I work with came into work yesterday wearing capris. And he's supposedly straight.
No, they probably thought it was funny. It was cool.
Oh, we was dying. Like me and my boy Roy was standing right there. Look, we just looked at each other like, he's wearing capris.
I would be clowning on this. Actually, I could just ignore him. Fuck him. That's some faggot shit.
I never in my life wore no capris, man.
You see so much faggot.
I ain't
faggot.
Never wanted a pair of capris.
No, it's women's clothes, isn't it?
Yeah, I've always thought.
You see so much faggot shit, it's done became mainstream.
Right.
It's like you get used to seeing all this faggot shit everywhere.
Yeah.
It's just fuck everywhere. You use a tranny on this corner, a faggot on that corner. Fucking whore, fuck a whore. You got fucking trannies walking everywhere.
These two bitches at work, one of them was a tranny. She's wanting to be referred to as a boy. So if you called him a girl or ma'am, she'll get offended.
Whoa.
They got in a fight on Facebook over it. Like two employees, they both got fired because the other girl was calling her a boy.
That's
a girl.
That's fucking crazy.
They all gonna get put to death.
That's right. I'm gonna call that motherfucker what I wanna call him.
Hell yeah.
Keep her in straight, lest she abuse herself through overmuch liberty. And that's freedom. if you don't understand. Because
you can't, right? If you got a good-looking woman or a daughter, you can't let them do nothing. I don't care if it hurts their feelings.
Yeah. If it, you know, are makes
people, oh, you too mean to her. Bitches, like, mind your own goddamn business. Right. She ain't going.
That bitch shouldn't even be allowed to have Facebook.
Hell, exactly. No Facebook. If you got a girlfriend, if she's got Facebook,
you got every count on everything.
She's cheating on you left and right.
She got a count on everything.
Snapchat.
Because when a bitch is on Facebook, she gets offered dick on a daily, repeatedly.
Yeah, bitches taking pictures or
selfies.
Videos.
Yeah.
Snapchat.
No, I seen this girl's Snapchat, phone last night.
That's that new shit.
Yeah, looking all. Well, you got a man, but you're over, you know.
They always give you them aerial views where you see right down their chest.
This bitch, I know, she gets 50 notifications every hour. Like, she be on Messenger all day long.
That's mad with extra shit on me.
Because you know how men are fucking. Men are like, what do you call them, horn dogs. And they just, you see a fine bitch on Facebook, you hitting all these bitches up. Just, you're going to get one of them. That's how men think.
Just friends.
What to them just friends means they just fuck them once a week, and they're not really serious. Yep. You know what I mean? But it's friends with benefits, they call it.
That's what it is.
FWBs.
That's what it is.
That's a new popular thing.
Policy. So when she fall out with your ass, she got that insurance policy. It's already laying there waiting, and you know that wicked motherfucker's there waiting.
Oh, he's right there.
She got them side niggas.
He'll fucking fight you over that whore.
That's right. Watch over an imprudent eye and marvel not if she trespass against thee.
It's like, don't be all amazed, be all heartbroken when you're
fucked up. Can't eat, can't sleep. You know, hey man, look, we about to go out and teach, bro. Oh, I can't go out. Man. He laying in the bed feeling sorry for himself and shit.
Or, that his daughter became a whore, his wife cheated on him.
Well, that's just reality, man. That's just real, man. We got to bring
when
it out.
When you
like
all going to learn, you only get your turn.
That's right.
Right. 50 Cent said that in a song.
50 Cent. That's a big
faggot. Curtis Jackson.
Oh, yeah, not even by nature.
OPP.
OPP.
Down with OPP.
And that was a hit. That was a hit. Yeah. I mean, that sold millions right there. That just tells you where these people's minds is at.
Another thing with these bitches, they get freedom. First, they're supposed to be cleaning, they're supposed to be cooking and everything like that.
They
get freedom. They don't clean. They don't cook. They go get little Caesars and shit.
And they got children. Right, you know what I'm saying? He said little Caesars.
Yeah. The convenient shit. You know, they ain't got no time to be cooking, man.
Shit, that these bitches call themselves little Caesars.
They barely got time to cut their, do their hair and shit. That's why they cut this shit. Or put weave in it, you know? They don't even want to spend time taking care of their pussy and shit. So they buy expensive ass. Chemicals
they
and just, mask the shit in their
pussy. They just sprayed a couple times.
Oh, I seen this nasty ass video today. Like, somebody posted it on Facebook. It showed the clit, and he opened it up, and it had maggots up inside of it.
Oh my god.
I'm like, how did that shit not get deleted?
Niggas be eating that shit up, too.
They can't
wait to eat some stinking pussy.
That'd be
Moab's
favorite right there.
Eat some stinking pussy.
Be like, ooh, some wax
I've
worms.
I've seen it done before.
Oh,
some stinking
remember that phone we found? I told you about that phone.
Don't bring that up.
That was some nightmare. We should have never. We deleted the pictures because they were so disgusting.
Yeah, that was nightmare pussy.
I mean, he took all kind of pictures of his pussy. It was on the SD card when we found his phone. And it showed, I hate to talk like this, but it showed the woman's pussy, and it was white. It was like flaky.
You ain't
like,
never hit no
ashy,
pussy that looked like that?
Like scaly, scabby. It was like somehow of a horror movie. And the dude I can't even show you what I seen in the picture. It was just the nasty, and he was in the picture smiling with it like. Like, no, he was proud of it. It was like he made a little porno or something he made.
That's some crazy shit.
I ain't never pulled a bitch's panties down and like started gagging like.
Oh yeah. Yeah, right.
And still hit it anyway.
No.
No,
hell no.
That's not funny.
Yeah, when I was young and dumb, 14, 15-year-old age, yeah, maybe then.
That's what Jake does, though.
Like, 14, fuck 15, it, I already 16, paid
I
for it.
I fucked everything and anything.
No, man.
Shit. I'd fuck a tree if I could have.
It's not funny.
That was when I was young, bro. That was back in the day, man. That's some foul shit.
But like that's you say, you see all these nasty women, these 300 pounders, 400 pounders.
300 and over.
Somebody's sliding up in there, man. Jake is nasty. Jake is a nasty, perverted demon.
Yeah, them big bitches over definitely cum dumpsters.
Yeah, right. And they just sitting at home just eating swine's flesh all day. You got all them parasites just brewing, and all them smells and funk just festering up in there.
That big bitch, boy, that nigga said he liked her, though, and she fall for that, man.
Like, baby, you so beautiful.
Yeah, baby, you thick.
Like, you get a
thick
thumbs
thick
up.
Thick is good, you know?
Didn't they have kids?
Thick,
the kids come out looking all retarded. Big-headed and shit.
Autistic.
Here you go.
Well, that comes from the vaccinations.
This is Proverbs 6 and 32. But whoso committeth adultery with a woman lacketh understanding. He that doeth it destroyeth his own soul. A wound and dishonor shall he get.
Ain't that what that song Two Phones is about? It's about adultery. Yeah, so you got one phone, so the other phone, so you don't get caught, right?
That's pretty much.
No, one's for the bitches and one's for the dough.
Yeah.
Is that what it says?
Yeah. But anyway, it's for men and women, though. It's encouraging for men and women. They have two phones. That's not just for men.
Yeah, because why you think a bitch got two phones?
Yeah, that's right. I told you that.
She got that secret phone.
That's right. That's right.
She said, I'm hiding my messages from my mom and shit.
Mm.
She got two
phones. See, they smart.
It's all about being
stupid. They smart and being wicked, man, being stupid. They smart and being stupid, if that makes sense.
But the Most High sees all of that.
Yeah,
that
makes sense.
You know what I'm saying? The Most High sees all that, man.
That's right.
It says, what is the most, the eyes of the Most High with the angels?
10,000 times.
Yeah, 10,000 times higher than the sun.
So ain't nothing getting by the Most High.
So ain't nothing, secret.
All the dark secret.
I'm gonna see if I can find a good scripture on that.
I get it.
There's a couple of, more than a couple. There's a bunch of them. I think it's a good one, the Psalms.
Here it is. This is the Ecclesiastes 23:19. Such a man only feareth the eyes of men, and knoweth not that the eyes of the Lord are 10,000 times brighter than the sun, beholding all the ways of men and considering their most secret parts. So all these motherfuckers with their secret societies, or where the fuck they doing their secrets and these goddamn temples, man, Most High's watching. The angels is right there recording all that bullshit, man.
Shit, the Most High put it in their spirit to do that.
Right, and check it out. You remember when King David, when he committed adultery, how he sent the letter? He sealed the letter and he gave it to the dude he had killed, to deliver it to this captain and had him killed. He thought that putting that letter, writing that letter in secret and sealing that letter, he thought he was doing it in secret, nobody's gonna know. So he, you know, that's just a little example of getting busted. And you can't hide shit from the Most High. I mean, like motherfuckers whispering and shit, you know.
Psalms 90:8. Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our secret sins in the light of thy countenance. That's one right there.
Secret sins.
They got them secret sins. What do they call them? The skeletons in the closet?
Hide them behind the pillars, eating swine's flesh.
I'm saying there's a bunch of scriptures on that.
What is the one they hide behind the pillars, cooking swine's flesh?
That's Isaiah 66.
Here you go. This is Job 34:21. For the eyes are upon the ways of man. For his eyes are upon the ways of men, and he seeth all his goings. There is no darkness nor shadow of death where the workers of iniquity may hide themselves. For he will not lay upon man more than right, that he should enter into judgment with the Most High. He shall break in pieces mighty men without number, and set others in their stead. Therefore he knoweth their works, and he overturneth them in the night, so that they are destroyed. He striketh them as wicked men in the opening of sight, in the open sight of others, because they turn back from him and would not consider any of his ways. That's some bad shit right there.
Oh, here, this is one I was really looking for. Psalms 44:21. Shall not God search this out, for he knoweth the secrets of the heart. I'm gonna get that, the whole chapter, real quick. Was that Psalms 44? I bet I just get more meat to that. Psalms 44. So I mean, you can lie to your fucking brother all you want. You can lie to your husband all you want.
Right.
So I can tell when someone's lying to me.
It's easy.
It definitely.
Because I've been a psychology has always been my shit.
And I let them go with it too.
Looking at people's behavior and their reactions and their, you know.
I'll let them think that I believe them too. You know what I mean? Just like, oh yeah, you got me, man. Yeah, you got me. You know what I mean? Just let them go. You know what I'm saying? Because then that's when you set their asses up.
Body language.
Yeah. It's obvious. Especially when a woman's cheating on you. That's real obvious.
You feel it. You feel it.
You feel it then.
You don't just know it. You feel it.
You just know something's wrong.
Right. This is 1 Peter 3:12. For the eyes of the Lord are over the righteous, and his ears are open unto their prayers. But the face of the Lord is against them that do evil. And who is he that will harm you if ye be followers of that which is good? But if ye suffer for righteousness' sake, happy are ye, and be not afraid of their terror, neither be troubled. But sanctify the Lord power in your heart, and be ready always to give an answer to every man that asks. I believe it just goes to so much.
Hey, let me read this. That's Psalms 44. This whole chapter is fire. Check this out. Psalms, I don't want to read the whole, it's pretty long, but I'm going to just start right here. Psalms 44, and where do I start? Psalms 44 and 5. No, 4. Thou art my king, O God, command deliverances for Jacob. Through thee will we push down our enemies. Oh, the Lord has enemies, does he?
God loved everybody.
What? Oh, wow. Through thee we will push down our enemies. Through thy name will we tread them under that rise up against us. Through the Lord's name. What's the Lord's name? Yahweh Basham, Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
It says the Lord's name.
That name is the root of salvation.
For I will not trust in my bow, neither shall my sword save me. Oh, that's a big cut to all them.
Buy me a sniper. Like,
Well, that's Jake though, huh? He be on Facebook with his AK-47 and all of his bullets and piles of money on the bed.
Yeah, right.
Dumbass, you know what I mean?
Dumbass.
Smiling with his front end.
Why that? The FBI. You just made a profile of yourself for the FBI. They didn't have to do no work. You gave it all to them.
FBI don't get out of bed.
Yeah, they just on. FBI really stays on Facebook. They on Facebook all day. That's where the FBI is at, on Facebook. And you dumb motherfuckers, tell them everything.
Don't even like, don't do field work. That's what it's called, field work.
Yeah,
field
work. That is the field work, yep. Facebook. Because Jake is so...
Until they go snatch their dumb ass. Because
Jake got that proud spirit. He'll put kilos of coke on Facebook.
Sure.
AKs, all the bullets, everything.
I've seen them put pounds of weed.
Pounds of weed, everything.
Yeah, I've seen that.
They be on Facebook, they'll be asking people who got the fire.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm trying...
Picture them smoking.
Yes. They put out a video of them smoking.
Yep.
Now they got videos.
Shit, I'm surprised they don't shoot dope on Facebook.
Hey, don't, I'm sure it's on there somewhere.
Yeah, you know it's on there.
I'm sure it's on there somewhere.
You got bitches hooking on there.
See them sucking dick and doing everything else on there.
They prostitute.
They don't censor that shit no more. They still don't.
What? They wanted. Yes. They wanted to go on.
Pornography and all that.
I don't even know.
They got closed groups where this shit's allowed.
Twitter don't either, do they?
Oh, Twitter. They don't censor nothing.
They do.
They censor shit like the political shit they don't like. Our shit's never got censored. That's what we're coming out with the truth.
I see all kinds of naked pictures on Twitter and
YouTube feed. Used to be the biggest censor.
That's why I seen the foulest shit on Twitter.
Twitter, yeah, it's some foul shit on Twitter.
Yeah, that's why I seen the men making porn that had pussies.
There's probably so many people using it now.
They made a big, it was a heavy hit, they say. It was all black men with pussies. That's what it was called, black men with pussies. And that's all it was black men that had their dicks cut off, man, making porn. Yeah, black man. That's
what
why I saw it on Twitter. Yeah. And it was on Twitter. They was, people was, you know, whatever, however you accept their Twitter account or whatever, man. It was large, man. They had millions of followers, man. Black men with pussies.
Here go that come and take him scripture. You know, come and take him. My cold dead hand scripture. Psalms 44:6. For I would not trust in my bow, neither shall my sword save me. Modern day sword's a gun. But thou hast saved us from our enemies, and hast put them to shame that hated us. In the Most High we boast all the day long and praise thy name forever, Salah. But thou hast cut off and put us to shame and goest not forth with our armies. We broke the Lord's commandments, you know what I'm saying? When you fall off, you start following the ways of the heathen, you start acting like a heathen, acting like you ain't got no goddamn sense, and the Lord is going to put you to shame. And look at is that our people put to shame?
That's crazy.
Thou make us to turn back from the enemy, and they which hate us spoil for themselves. That's what Esau's done to us. He's spoiled everything, taking our women, taking our children, taking our riches, taking our money, taking our land, everything. We ain't got shit.
But the Lord's name.
Yep. That's all you need. Yep. Thou hast given us like sheep appointed for meat and hast scattered us among the heathen. This is a deep chapter right here. So the Lord scattered Israel among the heathen. That's why he was teaching that Jake that was out here earlier. Probably Irish or something. You know what I mean?
He going join.
That's what his. That's all that. Yeah, they just met us, and she was serious. She's like, he wants to.
He didn't even hear nothing. We didn't barely even talk to him.
Right? She didn't get no more. She was serious, wasn't she?
Yeah, yeah.
He wants to join.
She liked what she heard though.
And that's funny that he lives by me too.
Does
she? Yeah, he lives off by right where I stay.
Oh wow.
I asked him where he's at. Yeah. Okay. He's hopping on the number two.
Yeah, she was coming off on the third. She liked what she heard.
Oh yeah, she gonna get.
She liked what she heard.
Hey.
And there are some women, wait a minute, I said some women on
there. They look like they had it rough, you know what I mean? So they probably went through all kind of hell. They got all kind of fucked up stories to tell.
You know they do, because they jakes.
Yep. All right, because that's the scripture right here.
You know the spirit when you see it.
It says, thy sellest thy people for naught, and dost not increase thy wealth by their price. Thou makest a reproach to our neighbors, and a scorn and a derision to them that are around about us. You see that all in the media every day, how Jake is being portrayed as, you know, savages and
they call themselves savages.
By words.
That's right. A new word. They call themselves savages.
Oh, yeah. I'm a savage. Oh, yeah. They do call themselves savages. That means wild. Savage is a Latin word. It means wild.
That's fucking crazy. They actually calling themselves that now.
Well, they called themselves goons. Remember when goons was the thing? Me and my goons?
I remember the goons shit. I remember that. That's some shit I just could not relate to.
Well, here it goes. Thou makest a byword among the heathen, a shaking of the head among the people. My confusion is continually before me, and the shame of my face hath covered me. For the voice of him that reproacheth them blasphemeth by reason of the enemy and avenger. All this has come upon us, yet we have not forgotten thee. Neither have we dealt falsely in thy covenant. That's talking about the elect right there, you know what I'm saying? Because we still get fucked up on a daily basis. I catch all kind of hell. There's a guy go to court, you get fucked up, cops is fucking with you, your old lady had cheat on you, you know, you get just fucked up left and right. I mean, that don't mean that you're going to curse out the Most High, you know what I mean?
Right.
You still recognize, oh, that's the Most High that did that to me.
That's right. Like the scripture said, don't think it's some strange thing when you start catching hell.
The scriptures tell you to pick up your cross.
Yeah, that's right.
He said, any man who does not pick up his cross and follow me is not worthy. Okay? So a cross is a heavy burden.
That's right. Like that goes with, that cross goes with we're a living sacrifice.
Yeah, we're a living
sacrifice. We're setting ourselves as
sacrifice. Oh, yeah. And
we're connecting the dots.
And we're sitting up that aroma.
That's some bad shit, man.
Yeah, because our sacrifices is a sweet savor to the Most High.
That's bad, man.
That is.
That's bad, man.
Hey, that's in Hebrews.
That's bad. That is bad. Let me just get it.
Yeah. Was that Hebrews 5 or 6? I can't remember.
Hey, I had to send him something like that. He was having a hard time. I could tell in the spirit, man. I could just tell in the spirit, man.
I know he got to deal with some bullshit.
Hey, curl up them loins.
Yeah.
Yeah, like man.
Oh, yeah.
Let me finish this up. Our heart is not turned back, neither have our steps declined from thy way. Though thou hast sore broken us in the place of dragons and covered us with the shadow of death. Ain't this the shadow of death out here? It's the valley of the shadow of death out here. You don't know when someone's gonna run up on you, shoot you. The cops can kill you at any minute. You think you just walking, you a free American? No, you ain't free. The cops will roll up on you and bust a cap in your ass and will kill you just because they can. And they'll get in no trouble. A cop will kill you. They'll get in no trouble. That's the Lord bringing that sword on you. Said Dodell has, I just read that. If we have forgotten the name, oh, look at this one. If we have, check this out. If we have forgotten the name of our God or stretch out our hands to a strange God, shall not God search this out? For he knoweth the secrets of the heart. We just went into the secrets.
That's right.
Yea, for thy sake are we killed all the day long. We are counted as sheep for the slaughter. So you get killed out here doing this work. We was out here teaching, a couple weeks ago, somebody they said they was about to get their nine and they was going to shoot us. You know what I'm saying? We had people pull knives on us. With that Humpty Dumpty video, dude he threw a beer on you.
For that, right? 412.
I mean, this is almost done. Awakest, awake, why thou sleepest thou, O Lord, arise, cast us not off forever.
No, I don't think so.
Go ahead, read the rest of it.
Like two or three times.
I don't know, man. I don't want to ride on
the phone. Sit here and listen to some scriptures, man.
Oh, God bless you. We and my brother just talked about it.
We prophets of the Lord, man.
God bless you, man.
Yeah.
I'm a saint of the Lord. For sure.
Yes, appreciate it.
This is the name of Chuck Skywalker, man. God bless all y'all.
I'm Elijah, man.
In the name of Jesus. Yes, sir.
Name of Yahweh Shah.
Yeah, Yahweh Shah is the Lord's true name in the ancient Hebrew. And Jesus is, that's English. The Lord wanted English means. You know
no, it wasn't. But you know what? I put it like I see it. There's many roles, many denominations, but we don't name but one Lord. Jehovah, I am. What is? You know how he's got many names.
He got one name.
But I'm talking about in mankind, in society. That's what I'm talking about.
Well, it's our job to come out here and teach you the proper name.
Yeah.
Because the Lord, he given us the name. You know what I'm saying?
What is his real name?
God's name is
Jehovah.
No, it's pronounced Yahweh.
There ain't no J.
There's no J's in Hebrew.
J is a recent letter that was just recently made in the 1700s. There was no J.
They know that.
Right. So he was Hebrew, so he gonna speak Hebrew,
yeah,
he's
definitely Hebrew, that's
so
right.
If you were Hebrew, you don't want me calling you some Greek. You don't know what the hell I'm saying.
You know what?
You know?
The King James Bible, I ain't gonna say this. Every Bible I got one of my favorite studies all the other. If you brought me to the word. You know what I mean? But like I say, I'm still in the United States. You know what I mean? I read every day, though.
That's why we out here.
Perfect say,
you know God's work right now. I do the same thing. I go make the brain, try to bring prayer together. I pray for people I see just lose some hope. You know what I'm trying to say? You know, you can look at a person and know. Lost soul.
Definitely.
Hope I ain't missed these buses. You know, Mike!
Yeah.
What's up, family?
Are you good?
I'm gonna bring this.
Oh, that's you!
Come on.
What's up, baby? I'm thinking about you, man.
First beer. Can't let that Jesus fly. I got some correction.
Jesus.
By the blood of Jesus.
What's that scripture? Psalm 119 says the Lord hates every false way.
Scripture says. What's highly esteemed among men is abomination to the Most High.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? This dude.
That's right, because all the liars in the world are like the thing we posted earlier. All the lies, all the liars become popular people in America or in this world, right? But if you teach any truth, they call you a psycho. You're crazy. Mm-hmm. You're crazy. But here it is, politicians tell you, oh, they got WMDs in Iraq. We got to go take down Saddam Hussein because Saddam Hussein has weapons of mass destruction. Just a big old lie, right? But if you pointed out that they lied, you're crazy. You're whack. You know what I'm saying? You're a loony.
Here you go, bro. This is Baruch 2:31. And shall I know that I am the Lord, their power? For I will give them a heart and ears to hear, and they shall praise me in the land of their captivity and think upon my name.
Yeah, so you're supposed to think about the Lord's name. The Lord's name does matter. The Lord does not have many names. He's got one name. What's that scripture says? That's a saying in Islam. Mm-hmm. The Lord has many names. They got like that 99 names of Allah or something. You know what I'm saying? But the Muslims don't know the Lord's name. They call him Allah, which means God in Hebrew.
Right.
It's just like a generic word for God. It means power, the power. That's what it means. It's not his name. It's a title.
Mm. Here you go. This is Baruch 2:11. And now, O Lord, power of Israel, that has brought thy people out of the land of Egypt with a mighty hand and high arm and with signs and with wonders and with great power, and has gotten thyself a name as appeareth this day. It don't change like they trying to throw out there, man. Oh, it's modern day now, so it's Jesus.
And the funny thing, when you get to that word, the name, how do you say name in Hebrew? Sham. Shall or Shem, Sham?
Oh, damn.
But okay. How do you say the word heaven? How do you say the word heaven?
Okay.
Shemayim.
Shemayim.
Shemayim. Shemayim.
Say the name again.
The heavens, it means the name, the heaven, it even has the word name in it. Even the word for the sun is Shamash. You know what I'm saying? Because the Lord created that sun.
He's like, fuck, where am I on this?
I got a scripture real quick.
Hey, yo, man, which one are you on there?
No one at this point is any one tribe. Well, we're all mixed up.
Well, no, he's right, because Israel got scattered among the heathen. We just got done talking about that.
Right.
Because our people have been scattered among all nations.
But you know spiritually, though. You can feel it spiritually.
Yeah.
You know, Israel used to be Palestine.
Nah, the Palestinians is Canaanites. The Palestinians are actually related to the Egyptians, who were Canaanites.
Philistines.
And they descend from Ham, while the Israelites descended from Shem. You see what I'm saying? Because Noah had three sons, Ham, Shem, and Japheth. The Palestinians descended from Ham. The Israelites descended from Shem.
The Lord just gave them that land. Gave us that land.
They used to be neighbors.
But all the Palestinians there today.
Well, they used to be neighbors, just like we are.
Those ain't the ancient Palestinians. Those are Arabs. Okay. And some of our people might be scattered over there too.
Right.
I said that the Palestinians of today do not descend from the ancient Palestinians. They're mostly the Arabic people. Or our people. Yeah. The Ishmaelites, you know Ishmael?
Ishmael.
You know who that is, right?
I know everything.
They're the Arabs, right?
He knows everything.
Arabic.
Yeah, Arabic. So
you gotta read the Quran.
Do they tell you the Quran speaks about Ishmael, right? Yeah. Who does it say the Quran is the people of the book?
Ishmael, who is the son of who?
It's the son of Abraham. There's Abraham had two sons, Isaac and Ishmael. Isaac, I'm saying, I'm trying to.
Who's Jacob?
Isaac and Ishmael.
Jacob.
Who's Jacob?
Promise wouldn't give it.
Yeah, the promise was given to Jacob, not Ishmael.
I'm asking you, who's Jacob?
Jacob's the father of Israel. He's Israel. He was the father of the 12 tribes of Israel. Who the Quran calls the people of the book. the Jews over there in Israel today, those ain't.
I don't give a fuck. I have a big knowledge than you ever had. Okay, it's Satlegan.
It's Satlegan.
They told there is the most clever people in the world.
He could
American.
Be for
so you're clever, right?
Okay, no, American is the most clever world. No, I'm not clever. They told the most clever people in the world is American. And they are born and they smoke cigarettes.
No, what's saying?
What do you think about it?
Stop with me. Stop.
So tell me about
I'm
the Jews.
Too much.
Tell me about the
Jews. You probably know about someone.
I'm too much for them.
Yeah. Well, tell me about the Jews in Israel today. The so-called Jews in Israel.
Maybe I can't understand.
Are they good people?
Rats.
Jews.
Israeli people?
Yeah, Israelis. Jewish.
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 Israeli rats.
They are my cousins.
They're your cousins?
I'm Arabic. They are my cousins.
Well, yeah, you're right. You're right, but they're a bunch of devils.
I don't care. Bunch of devils here, bunch of devils here.
But they slaughtered your people. They killed all those, they killing all those
not people. Not more than you, what you do in Iraq.
Exactly, not me, that's not my people.
I don't mean you, I don't mean it's yeah. Not more than America what you do in Iraq.
Exactly, but who's America controlled by, the so-called Jew?
Jews.
The Jews, this is the United States of America. Right? All right, the United Slaves of America. Who owns all these banks? Huntington. Look, they got a 6-point star on the Huntington sign. The Jews own all the banks. They run everything. So the Iraq war was a Jewish war. The war...
Why you put yourself on that?
Huh?
Why you put yourself on that? We know our enemy. Why you put yourself...
They're not really Jews. They're Edomites. Esau.
Listen, we don't talk anything with America.
I'm not American.
We love America. Listen, we love America. We love everything.
Fuck America.
They good, they fair more than anybody else.
What?
That's the truth.
They're fair?
They fear more than anybody.
They charge usury. You know what usury
fear.
Is?
You say fear?
He said they're fair.
Oh. If I look to my country, I look to your country, they are more fair.
Now you lost it. You gone.
You're crazy.
You went off there. You went off there.
Have you been to the hood?
No, it's not true. That's not true. This place. Well, you can't understand this
language. America is the kingdom of Satan.
But this is a deceitful-ass nation.
Are you down with ISIS?
It deals with nothing but deceit, you know?
ISIS was created by the United States government.
ISIS created for them, and they will kill you, not me. They will kill you, not me. They created from here.
He say America's fair. America's fair, right? So a woman can commit adultery on a man, take his money and the children. And that's fair. That's fair, right?
Because that I'm sitting.
What happens in the Middle East if a woman commits adultery?
That happened to you?
Stone that bitch with stones.
That happened to you? So you consider that fair?
That's fair, right?
You consider that fair?
That's evil.
It's not about the country.
That's wickedness, man.
That is
the country. Listen to me. It's not about the country.
It is about
it's
the country.
It's about the trash people.
I don't think he even knows what I'm saying.
I'm sorry. But I will tell you the truth. You will enter with me in big interview. But we know. God bless you.
Camera down, man.
It's about to be here. The battery light's on.
Say God bless America, too.
God bless every motherfucker in the world.
What you drinking, man?
I'm Muslim.
You're part of ISIS.
I'm Muslim, not ISIS. ISIS, not Muslim.
All Muslims are ISIS.
They killed my Bible, man.
And the Most High said, Sarah, thy wife shall bear thee a son in thee. And thou shalt call his name Isaac. And I will establish my covenant with him for an everlasting covenant, and with his seed after him. And as for Ishmael, I have heard thee. Behold, I have blessed him, and will make him fruitful, and will multiply him exceedingly.
And they multiply exceedingly and conquer the Middle East and conquer Constantinople.
All the Holy Quran here, man. All of it.
Shall he
begin. I don't care about what.
And I will make him a great nation.
I'm
but my covenant will be established with Isaac.
Hey, this is the holy book right here.
This is with the holy Isaac book. In the holy book.
This is the holy book. It's the Bible, not the Quran.
How many copies you have for the Bible?
One.
No, you lying.
No, Hebrew.
You have more than
Hebrew
copy.
No, there's, no, it's not.
Hey, ain't the Quran supposed to be in Hebrew?
Buddy, give me the right Bible.
It's a Hebrew Bible and a Greek Bible. The Old Testament is Hebrew. The New Testament, we speak English now. Because our people, they forgot our language.
The right Bible is in Latin.
No, it's not. That's the Latin Vulgate. No. That's the Catholic Bible.
We have a lot of books. We have one book. Muslims, we have
my
one book.
I can't hold this.
Where did that start from?
It's about
It started from the Catholic Church.
I
Yeah, that's where Islam started from, the Catholic Church. The so-called Negroes started the Islam religion.
Oh, so, that's good, you good.
Work your heart. Break your heart. All right, let me read some.
Y'all stole the head covering from us.
I was just teaching people. This is for our brothers that we teach.
I got your ideals for the Israelites, too. The head covering, the what else?
Don't eat pork.
Beer. Yeah, the pork.
Pork's in the... And that's in the Bible.
I don't talk about basic things. I talk about deep things. What's listen
deep?
To me.
We talk about deep things too.
No, you talk about don't eat pork, don't gambling, don't blah, 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 have.
We never said nothing about gambling. You're allowed to gamble.
No.
Yes, you are.
No.
And you're allowed to drink too.
You see?
According
you see,
to Muslims,
you have knowledge. Wrong.
How's that?
We're not,
show me the scripture that says don't gamble.
Allowed. I'm going to.
That's
to
a Muslim.
Because I'm drinking.
There's no
look,
such thing as hell.
The secret Jesus. Vatican briefings on the creating of the Prophet Muhammad. Let me read on. How about a comic book form of publications of importance of press history about the Jesuit Vatican hand in the creation of Islam and Islam's founder, the Prophet Muhammad? According to the introduction
why,
to what you are about to read.
Why Hitler burned the Jews?
Those aren't real Jews. The Holocaust never happened. The Jews are liars. They lie about everything. There was no Holocaust.
I'm drunk, man.
Too much. All right. Oh, peace of Shalom. All praises to Yahweh Ba'a Shem Yahweh Shai.
I have one.